So welcome everyone. Tonight is Monday, September 21st, 2020. This is the Town of Halifax Finance Committee meeting. We're being recorded on Zoom. On tonight's agenda, we have an interview with Tom Connolly for appointment to the Finance Committee, budgets, reserve fund transfers, line item transfers, acceptance of minutes, correspondence, public participation, calendar, and as may arise. Tonight will be a pretty quick night, but I still appreciate everyone being here. So first up, we have an interview with Mr. Tom Connolly, who's interested in the Finance Committee. So I see that we have most of the committee here now. So I was wondering, committee members, if you'd like to take turns just introducing yourself, and if you have a role on the Finance Committee, or how long you've served, anything that you think might be helpful to know, just so we can, so everyone can get to know everyone else.
Hi, Tom. My name's Cheryl Zarella Burke. I've been on the Finance Committee since October of last year.
Thanks, Cheryl.
My name's Drew. I'm the newest person on the Finance Committee. I've been on the Finance Committee for a little less than a year.
Thanks, Drew.
And my name's Frederick McGovern-Tom. I've been on the Finance Committee since November of 2018. Currently, I act as the clerk for the Finance Committee.
Thanks.
And I'm Melinda Tarsi. I'm the chair of the committee. I think I've been on for 3 years now, at least three budget cycles. So I'm really grateful to have you tonight. I don't know if you'd like to introduce yourself, whatever information you'd like to tell us about you, why you're interested in, I know you checked off a bunch of different potential committees and boards, but sure. Why you're interested in serving.
So thank you. And thank you everyone for your time tonight. As Melinda said, I'm Tom Connolly. I submitted a talent bank form with a number of committee possibilities. My family and I moved to Halifax about 9 years ago. I was mainly working on Wall Street. We came up here to help turn around a pharmaceutical company in Boston. And it just feels like time to get more. We love this town. We just have had such a great experience here. Coming out of New York City and moving into a town like this has been just a phenomenal experience for us. And I'm actually in a position now with work where the firm's doing well. I've turned that around, so I have some time, and just this seemed to make sense for us. So I've been to, you know, lots of town meetings. Always it's one of those anonymous people in the audience that are just kind of trying to learn. I've been through the last six or seven sets of minutes. While I've got lots of finance training and experience, I've got a ton to learn about municipal government. So it was clear, just the vernacular, the tone, everything that was there was very new to me. So it was really just a general interest in wanting to participate in the town that got me here.
Awesome, thank you. And I think one of the things across every member, none of us come with a background in municipal finance in particular. But what's really nice is that everyone's got a little bit of a different set of experience, educational training, et cetera. So it makes for really great conversations. One thing I'll note too is that the state and a nonprofit that's affiliated with the Massachusetts Municipal Association called the Association for Town Finance Committees runs trainings for folks who are new to finance committees or financial positions. I'm a director on the ATFC board, so I can keep folks posted about those trainings, but those tend to be really helpful too, just to get the lingo and understand how taxes are levied, how we calculate things like Prop 2.5, all that kind of stuff. So
yeah.
There's lots of opportunities to sort of on-ramp.
Oh, that's great.
So we also have tonight our Finance Committee Secretary Linda and a town accountant Sandy Nolan. And it looks like our final Finance Committee member, Bill McAvoy, who's also our vice chair, was able to join and is in a very impressive office or library.
Virtual background. Sorry, I'm late.
No problem. So I can fill in a tiny bit about the Finance Committee, and then FinCom folks, if I miss anything or leave anything out, feel free to tag in. I think one of the most important things to note about it, and you probably, or you may have seen this on some of the websites and the materials, is that the Finance Committee is one of the very few or only ones where service on the Finance Committee basically excludes you from service on many, many other committees because of our work
conflict
with the budget. Exactly. Sure. There's a couple committees that we are able to serve on, like capital planning and wage and personnel, although that was just voted to be disbanded once town meeting adjourns. And in many other towns, the finance committee is actually called the advisory committee, because whether or not, as you've seen at town meeting, the articles are explicitly about budget, the finance committee still provides a recommendation. Mm-hmm. So I think it's the best committee to get a really wide view of everything that's going on in town. Mm-hmm. You get to interact with every department, you get to interact with all the other boards and committees. So in that way, it's fascinating. Our busy season tends to be sort of January, February, March, April, and then May or town meeting. Obviously this year is completely odd that we're having town meeting in September. Normally the budget process starts in December when we ask the departments to submit their budgets by the first or second week of January, and then we sort of go from there. Each FinCom member is assigned liaison roles to multiple departments, and all that means is that FinCom member will be the point person for that department as we get the budget submissions. And Sandy and Linda are awesome about making sure that we get electronic copies, paper copies, whatever we need to look at. Those liaisons can then meet with those department heads, phone call, email, in person, whatever works, and just clarify any questions. And those liaisons aren't meant to act as advocates for those departments. They're merely there to clarify. So then when we're having conversation amongst ourselves, that liaison can say, oh, I talked to so-and-so, I think they're leaning this way, or I think this is what they mean by this request. We still bring those department heads in, and all the committee and board heads in that are requesting funding during the budget process. We have meetings with those folks, and a lot of the conversations and a lot of the actual work of, resolving how we can fit the requests into what's available for that year happens there. And then we present our recommendations at town meeting and at special town meeting. Our official schedule is two nights a month, two Monday nights. It doesn't have to be Mondays. We could chat soon as a group and decide another night works better for us. Same thing with time, especially now that we've moved online. We've inched our time a little bit, but that can be moved around too. It's all at the whatever's the convenience of the committee members at that time. Our meetings are all open and public, so we have the rules about 2 days notice on postings. We're always video recorded. And when we're able to have meetings in person, they're in the first selectman, or they're in the selectman's meeting room, usually at town hall. Mm-hmm. Once we get past town meeting, June and July tend to be the reconciliation, is when we're reconciling the fiscal year. So that's when we might have to do line item transfers, things like that. But basically the summer we take off, and then early fall, we sort of start ramping up or prepping. That's also when a lot of the trainings tend to be, is like September, October, November. A lot of the state-run trainings for other finance committee members tend to happen then to get folks ready for the budget cycle. FinCom folks, Sandy, Lynn, did I miss anything?
I don't think so.
No.
Thanks, it was great, thank you.
No problem. So in terms of time commitment, a night like tonight, when we're really just doing, when we're having an interview or we're going to vote on some meeting minutes, I think we'll be done in about half an hour. Right. When we're not working on the budget, though, sometimes we have 15-minute meetings, I would say no longer than an hour, just to do the housekeeping stuff. When we're in the budget season, we tend to have longer meetings, but our kind of group consensus has been that rather to have, a 4-hour meeting, we might say, okay, let's do Monday night. Let's try to find another night during the week that we can do another hour and a half. Cause I feel like no good decisions get made after 11 PM. Right. There's no need for that. in terms of time commitment, that's sort of where it is. Obviously, like I said, the most time is spent in those months there. But certainly we can be really flexible, like I said, about scheduling. Trying to think if there's anything else in terms of scheduling, sort of workload, the purview of the committee, the training opportunities, the ability to interact with other departments. I've served on wage and personnel as a FinCom representative for a couple years, and I love FinCom far more. I did not necessarily want to be on FinCom. I like you checked off a bunch of committees, and I got pulled into a FinCom meeting first. I was like, fireworks sounds more fun.
Right.
But it's ended up being an incredible experience, and we've had different members cycle on and cycle off. And I have to say, like, we've always worked together really well, no matter who's on. We don't always agree, but we've never devolved into screaming matches or anything like that. It's always, I think, super respectful, really courteous, and very constructive. And I don't know if the other FinCom members have any other sort of takes or opinions on what the process has been like being on the finance committee.
Yeah, I mean, I agree. I think this year we probably had more non-unanimous votes in my entire time on the FinCom committee. And mm-hmm. as you said, very respectful dissension and differences of opinions.
Yeah, I kind of noticed that from reviewing the minutes. There's a lot of AIFs on the, it just seems like, you know, unanimous decisions and that sort of thing. And it seemed like very, very, really sort of patient deliberation went into a lot of what I saw there. So. Yeah, it's fascinating to see.
Yeah, and I think we're really proud of that that culture, I guess, that organizational culture, if you want to call it that. Yeah. I know some other boards and committees don't necessarily have that kind of discussion, but I think...
Yeah, that's not the vibe I get sometimes at town hall. Right?
Yeah. But that's what's nice is because we all do come from very different... So, like, I'm a professor of public administration and political science, and we have folks from software and finance and higher ed admin and... the environmental sector. So we're all coming at it from very different angles, but like you said, we're all taxpayers. We've all got different stakes in what the town does. So I think that's what makes it really constructive.
Yeah. Thanks.
So do you have any questions for us or anything I didn't touch on about what the committee does?
No, I think you've covered so much ground between this it's clear for the minutes. As I said, there's a lot of vernacular and things that there's clear story behind a lot of the minutes that aren't in the minutes. So there's a lot of kind of picking up that depth that would be a challenge. Mm-hmm. I think I have a clear sense of the time commitment that would be required. I'm up for that. I've got flexibility. My wife jokes I can work any 18 hours a day that I want. So we've got complete flexibility there. My firm has been on 100% remote since March. So I'm in town all the time. My office is in Quincy, but I'm here all the time. So I'm happy to answer any other questions that you guys might have. But I think I have a sense of, you know, clearly as I'm going to be clearly the rookie, maybe that gives Drew a promotion. So I can, you know, I can, but clearly it'd be a ton to learn.
Awesome. So any other members of the finance committee or Linda or Sandy have any questions?
I do not have any questions, but if Tom chooses to join us, I'd be more than happy to mail out a quick little cheat sheet kind of that we have of a couple pages long, just giving you some of the terms that you might be seeing that, you know, as you're saying, the vernacular and just how they work with government to come to those, what we're talking about or how we're taxing or the levy limits and things like that. So that we can kind of give you a little look at. So.
That would be great. And it's great to hear that there's some education on the side. I'm deeply involved in a lot of a big state government project right now. And that's been a vertical learning curve as well. So yeah, any cheat sheets that we've got, that'd be great.
Sure. Awesome. Great. And I think the committee members should have just gotten the email about the Association of Town Finance Committee is doing their annual meeting, but I'll make sure to send that out to everyone too who's interested. They're all going to be virtual and they're going to be 1-hour evening sessions, but that has budget workshops, things for new finance committee members, things about what COVID is doing to the budget, a lot of different really relevant topics. So I'll make sure to pass that along to folks as well. So Tom, if you're still interested, what we can do is you don't have to, please feel no pressure now. If you want some time to think about it, you're more than welcome. But if you are interested, then what we can do is take a vote as a committee to make a recommendation in the Board of Selectmen. So the appointment process is essentially the Finance Committee gets a vote, the Board of Selectmen do a vote, and the town moderator all contribute. Okay. And the town moderator votes as well. And the town moderator and Board of Selectmen, I think, tend to ask the same questions that we asked and make sure that the person understands the workload and things like that. So. Sure. If you'd like some time to think about it, like I said, don't feel pressured, but if you want us to move forward, then we can do that as well tonight, or we can.
Yeah, no, not at all. I'd love to move forward. I'm interested. Awesome. It seems like a great committee. It's a way to be productive, mm-hmm. in the town. So, you know, this would be, yes, I'm absolutely interested. Thank you.
Awesome. That's great. So then from the Finance Committee, I would entertain a motion for the Finance Committee to recommend the appointment of Tom Connolly to the, we'll say the vacancy with the long, so let me pause for a second. The term is a 3-year term, and what we usually do is appoint the newest person to the term that has the longest left to go before the next reappointment.
Understood.
So that's how I'll ask the motion worded. So I would entertain a motion for the Finance Committee to recommend the appointment of Tom Connolly to the Finance Committee vacancy with the longest term available to be recommended to the Board of Selectmen.
So moved.
Second.
Motion and second. Any further discussion? Okay, I'll do roll call since it's a Zoom meeting. All those in favor, Cheryl?
Aye.
Bill?
Aye.
Drew?
Aye.
Fred?
Aye.
And myself, Melinda, aye. I'm so excited. Thank you, Tom.
Thanks, guys. Thanks very much.
No problem. So we will communicate our vote to the Board of Selectmen. They will set up a time to have you virtually join them at a Board of Selectmen meeting to chat. They'll take a vote there with the town moderator. One of us will attend that meeting as well and represent the vote that we just took. And then assuming that process continues, there'll be a swearing in. And which you can just schedule with the town clerk, and sure. That's basically it.
Okay, I appreciate your time. Thank you, guys. You made that easy. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I'm so excited.
Have a good evening.
Bye. Thank you too.
You as well.
Okay, awesome. So we just have a few quick things. So obviously, on the topic of budgets, we're going to be and calendar. Quite frankly, we'll be reconvening town meeting tomorrow night. I was asking Sandy before some of you logged on. It sounds like the Board of Selectmen are going to potentially consider lowering quorum at their meeting tomorrow. So if anyone has feelings about that or wants to be part of that discussion or communicate that sentiment to the Board of Selectmen, tomorrow would be when they're going to discuss it. Otherwise, we will be at the elementary school tomorrow night at 7:30 p.m. Assuming we can achieve quorum, we can hopefully wrap up the rest of the town meeting. The only other thing we had on tonight's agenda were the meeting minutes from 9:17, which was the other night when we met at the mall. So then I would entertain a motion to approve the meeting minutes from Saturday, September 17th. Oh, wait, I guess, is this
Thursday?
Thursday. So I would entertain a motion to approve the meeting minutes from Thursday, September 17, 2020, with the one correction to change the day of the week on the meeting minutes. The members present were Melinda Tarsi, Bill McAvoy, Cheryl Zarella-Burke, Fred McGovern, and Drew McClensey.
I'll make a motion to accept minutes from Thursday, September 17th.
Seconded.
Moved and seconded. Any further discussion? Okay, all those in favor? Roll call, Cheryl?
Aye.
Bill?
Aye.
Drew?
Aye.
Fred?
Aye.
And myself, Melinda, aye. Thank you so much, Linda, for doing those for us.
Sure.
The last thing is under correspondence, we have a letter from the Silver Lake Regional School District that was sent to the Board of Selectmen, but we were copied on it, that the just informing us of the additional substitute teacher that it sounds like the Board of Selectmen has approved the request. So, Sandy, can I ask you a quick question? Our assessment isn't changing. This is just sort of a notification, or do you think this is going to change the assessment?
Right. No, this shouldn't change the assessment. What they're doing is putting it like having a building sub,
mm-hmm.
and we're hoping that it gets taken care of through the CARES Act,
right?
Which would be through the end of December. After that, Halifax will not be responsible for the money. They'll have to find it within their budget.
Okay.
So we'll see what happens after that.
Okay. Awesome. Public participation. Any members of the public want to ask questions or take part?
Melinda, the only other thing I want to say, on the way out today, there was one other piece of correspondence from Sandy, and I will bring it tomorrow night.
Okay.
It's just looking for the committee members' names and signatures, and then whoever wants to be the signatory for payroll. So I'll have, if you're all there tomorrow night, I'll get everybody to sign on that form tomorrow night.
Awesome. I actually meant to ask you the other night too, Linda and Sandy, if we have payroll to sign, if you wouldn't mind bringing
it with us.
Is that okay to bring it to another location?
If I'm doing it, it's okay.
Yeah. Okay. I'm
not supposed to hand it off to anyone, but I'll bring it.
Well, I was going to say, because if you need me to run to town hall tomorrow, I could pop in and do it too.
I'll bring it with me.
Okay.
That would be easiest.
Okay.
All right. Melinda, do you want us there early tomorrow night?
I just put it on at 6:45. So if you happen to all be there prior to, it's not a problem. So I think you're all set.
Yeah, I would say like maybe like 15 minutes before the meeting's supposed to start, like 7:15. Okay. But like, yeah, so like Linda had to post at that time because if we all happened to gather at that moment and started to talk, then we're
considered a meeting. Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Better safe than sorry. That's the only reason I put it early.
Yeah, right. Like even if we're just talking about Halloween costumes, it's an open meeting at that point. So.
So Melinda, do they announce what the quorum reduction is going to be or the new quorum is for tomorrow?
No, they're going to discuss the possibility of lowering it. There's no assurance that they will. There's no, but they had to post notification. They were going to talk about it.
Okay. Is there a certain amount of, I guess, hours required for that notification to be communicated before you can actually reduce the quorum?
Yeah. So that was that email that got, it went to the like blast or the listserv, the town listserv. Charlie sent it out and they indicated that they would discuss it on September 22nd. Because on Thursday night, I had asked, I think Sandy and Linda, I was like, you guys get the email, and it didn't come to us through like our FinCom emails. It went through the, like the town email listserv.
Yeah. Cause I didn't see that.
Yeah.
I think you have to be signed up on the website for the town emails. Uh-huh. Blasted.
You do.
Yeah.
And I'm presuming he probably posted it on the website too.
And I would think I'm not on the Facebook page, but I would assume it might be there. Or at least folks are gonna be talking about there, but yeah, it's the same email list where you get the COVID updates and stuff like that. So if folks aren't on it, it's good to get it. You don't get a ton of emails, but you do get like helpful stuff like that. Notification board of selectmen meetings, those kind of things.
So the town meeting's tomorrow night, right?
Oh, sorry, I didn't hear you.
Yeah.
Town meeting's tomorrow night. So if we didn't take the vote to reduce the quorum, there's a possibility that we can't make quorum tomorrow night because we didn't reduce it in time.
Well, the Board of Selectmen is going to have a meeting tomorrow. So they have to give notice that they're discussing it. They have to give at least, I think, 2 or 4 days notice, whatever the law says that they're discussing it. But then once they've given notice, they can make the decision that day, and that can be the same day of town meeting.
Okay.
So yeah, so like they basically have that meeting set so they can decide if they want to lower it. And if they do, then they're square for lowering it for that night.
Yeah, we think they will.
I mean, like me as a person, not me as a FinCom member, I hope that they will because it doesn't set a cap, right? So we can still get 150 people if we want, but like once X number of people are in the door, we can just start handling business, which I think would be great.
Yeah.
Yeah, the website agenda was dated on the 18th, so it's plenty of time.
And they, because I'd asked Charlie, they did check with town council to, because we thought they had to make that decision before town meeting began. So like basically once we started on the 12th, it was done, but that wasn't the case. And they confirmed with town council that they can readjust quorum with due notice, even when we're like adjourning and re-adjourning.
Yeah, from what I heard, it had to be more than 7 days, which it has been since the original time that we all met, so.
So under calendar, I think we're set, like we said, for October, I think it was 5th and 19th. Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So we'll go ahead and hold those dates. Linda, do you want me to contact the Board of Selectmen about Tom's appointment? Because I'm happy to be the person who pops in the Board of Selectmen meeting and does the vote for him.
I can definitely send out the email if you just to the, because I'll send out his information tomorrow.
Oh.
So if you just want to, there's not a particular date or time that won't work for you, is there?
Yeah.
Whenever their next meeting is, they'll probably, I'm sure, put them on right away on the next meeting because they'll be eager to get somebody on.
Yeah. No, yeah, like as soon as they want to make it, I can just pop in for the vote and pop out. So that's totally fine. Yeah.
So are they meeting tomorrow before the FinCom meeting? Because they usually meet Tuesdays, right?
Yeah, they're going to be meeting tomorrow. I've got the town, let me see, they have the website open now.
I think just prior to the town meeting.
Yeah, it's 6 p.m.
But no, but they also have a Board of Selectmen meet. Oh, wait, they had a meeting today at 1:30.
Right.
Yeah, so I would think for Tom, it wouldn't be till the next meeting after tomorrow night, I would guess, is when they'd schedule him.
Yeah, they have a couple of scheduled appointments tomorrow night. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and it looks like they have another meeting scheduled for the 24th. They already have one for the 28th, so like they might be able to pop him on to one of those. Mm-hmm. Okay. Cool. All right. We got calendar done. Anything else under As May Arise?
I don't think so. Not here.
All right. So I guess we'll see everyone in person tomorrow at the elementary school. I would entertain a motion for us to adjourn at 6:25 p.m.
So moved.
Second.
Moved and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right. Great. Thanks so much, everybody. Take care.
Good night.